begins.
The Empire's trying to drive us from Taris, from our homes. Soon they'll learn that Cathar never backed down.
Keep talking, Mashun. When I get out of here, I'll stomp out your entire species.
The Empire sent this Sith to kill me, but she failed. Proof that none can defeat the mighty Cathar.
There's no point resisting.
The Empire just doesn't know when to quit. You know, Cathar aren't the only settlers on Taris. The Nikto have joined us, along with their Morgukai warriors. We're all refugees, fleeing the Empire's cruelty. And I promise you, my Cathar, we won't be uprooted again.
Nice speech. Uplifting, really. But they'll be disappointed when I kill you.
Don't be so sure. I have the Morgukai and the Republic on my side. Watch closely, fellow Cathar. Witness our enemy's downfall.
It's not over. Keep fighting.
Stay on Taris, and you'll share Bashun's fate.
That'll send those beasts running off planet.
Now, why don't you come over here? Let me out. I'm sure there's some way I can make it up to you.
Stay in there a while. Think about that attitude of yours.
I'm going to escape. And when I do, you'd better be long gone.
Thank you.
I intercepted Bashun's final transmission. Magnificent work. His death was gratuitous, but effective. The Cathar are abandoning their homes in terror.
I did what I had to.
And the results speak for themselves.
There you are. 3 meters of durasteel. That's what I cut through to escape my cell.
I was out of line, I'm sorry.
Apologies won't cut it. Next time I see you, you're dead.
What was that, Thana? Your transmission, it's breaking up. Much better. I've heard enough of her ranting. Lord Gravis expects you to lead our final attack. Regretfully, I can't join you. My duties here, wiping out any resisting Cathar. Head to the Republic outskirts, meet Lord Shaythan. When flames and evac shuttles choke the skies, I'll know you've crushed the Republic base.
A surrender or a treaty. We always admire the soldiers stationed in places like these.
Keep your voice down. I'm almost certain this room is bugged. The Republic may be monitoring our every word. I'm Lieutenant Trace. I've been tracking Republic signals buzzing in and out of this base for weeks. I finally had to put a lockdown on all outgoing transmissions. My men can't even speak to their own mothers without my say-so.
Good. You dealt with the problem before it got out of hand.
Still, there's no telling how much information has already been leaked. You see this? It's a Republic transmitter. One of my men, dead now, tried to plant one under my desk a few weeks ago. I traced the bug's signal to a nearby Republic listening post, a communications hub of some sort. Turns out, that listening post houses one of the Republic's primary satellite arrays. It's the keystone of their entire communications network on Taris.
Sounds like an ideal target.
I knew you'd see the silver lining. We have an opportunity here to end Republic snooping, leave their spies cut off, and their forces running blind. Unfortunately, I don't know which of my men I can trust, so I need you to run this one. Can you destroy that listening post?
Protecting the Empire's secrets is what I do.
Then this'll be right up your alley. Knock out the satellite array, and you'll render the entire listening post inoperable. Remember, though, that place is a military facility, and anyone who can survive in that wilderness will be a formidable opponent.
Lord Shaythan at your service. I was relieved to hear you'll be leading our assault. Judging by your track record, the Republic's grip on Taris is about to be broken. Darth Gravis, your friend has arrived.
You've performed well. Taris is scarred. The Republic's support weakened. I trust you're ready to deliver the killing blow.
The Republic won't survive another day on Taris.
Such conviction will prove necessary in the fight ahead. Centuries ago, Darth Malak began the destruction of Taris. We're about to complete his work. We will crush the Republic reconstruction and the Jedi responsible. Thanks to you, they're cornered in their base. Their final sanctuary on Taris.
And soon to be their tomb. Don't worry, Gravis. I'll tear down their base, then soak Taris with Republic blood.
This operation demands an expert. Not some rabid attack dog.
A little carnage is exactly what the Republic needs.
Fana, I knew you'd come running at the first scent of blood. Unfortunately, the base's approach is infested with Republic forces. They're blocking our army's advance.
Rain bombs on their heads.
They're shielded. Only close combat will work.
Shields are not. I want them pulverized.
Without their defenses, Thana can catch the Republic forces off guard.
Break the machines if you want. I'm more of a blood and bruises woman.
Clear the battlefield, then we'll hit the Republic base and finally drive them off Taris.
All the Republic channels suddenly turn to static. By the time they get everything back online, we'll have already mopped up their scattered forces. Nicely done.
The Republic had you bugged. Your men need to be dealt with.
Don't worry. With no one to transmit to, they won't be able to do any harm. Sooner or later, they'll get desperate and slip up. I'll do a thorough check for any remaining bugs, and have the other bases do the same. We'll purge those spies yet.
Darth Gravis, it appears we're ready.
I disabled the Republic's shields. It's all up to Thana now.
I killed them all. Didn't even break a sweat.
Fantastic work, both of you. You must act quickly before the Republic deploys reinforcements. Lord Sheathan, begin the attack.
At once, my lord.
The final battle for Taris has begun. If we are to demolish this planet, you and Thana must join forces.
I'm willing to put aside our differences. If she is.
No. You've dragged me down long enough.
The Republic's annihilation demands your complete cooperation, Thana.
I'll help, Gravis. If only to prepare for the day I strike you down.
Splendid. Your mission is twofold. Blow up the Republic spaceport, and eliminate the leader of their reconstruction efforts, a powerful Jedi Master named Serik.
Such a loss will be devastating. The entire galaxy will take note.
What better way to drive them off than humiliation by defeat? Once Master Serik falls, the Republic will be forced to abandon Taris. The spaceport's destruction will block their reinforcements and trap the doomed survivors here.
Darth Gravis, the attack's underway. Republic transports are in orbit, headed for their spaceport.
They're trying to flee. If we don't kill Master Serik now, he'll return with a full occupation force.
I'll remove Serik and end his pathetic reconstruction.
Be careful. That Jedi knows he's fighting for more than himself. Infiltrate the Republic base. Disable the spaceport safety measures. Then meet Thana in the lower levels. Only together can you destroy the Republic's dreams.
And don't keep me waiting.
If you get the chance, take out the Republic's assault cannons. They're making life painful for our boys.
victorious.
Under control.
We need to kill Serik and blow this place now.
Way ahead of you. Since you finally disabled the Republic's safety measures, I can force their power grid to go critical and... What? Ugh! The spaceport's set to blow, but those blasted Jedi installed a failsafe. Let's find Serik and rip the override code from his dead hands.
For the next.
Calm the evacuees. The transports will be ready any moment now. The Republic will not lose Taris.
Taris's reconstruction dies here, with you.
Finally, the intruders show themselves.
I'm going to enjoy killing you, Serik.
Darth Gravis is amazingly predictable. This is a trap, and you walked right into it. The evacuation transports that arrived weren't empty. They brought friends, ready to defend Taris. Perhaps you're familiar with them?
You'd need an entire fleet of reinforcements to take me down.
I think we'll do just fine. This is it. Defend Taris with your lives.
Thank you.
well.
Too bad there aren't more of them. I was just getting warmed up. And what do we have here? Ah, Sarek's failsafe code. This in, and there. The power is overloading. So long, Republic.
The Republic gone, nothing will save this planet from destruction.
You and Gravis can celebrate together. Meanwhile, I'll... Wait a second. Those transports that brought Sarek's backup, they're loaded with civilians. They're actually trying to open the hangar. They'll escape the explosion.
Open the hangar. They've already lost enough.
You really know how to sap the joy out of a good massacre. The hangar's open. And there they go. What a waste. This place is about to explode. Much as I'd like to see you disintegrated, I suggest you run. Or stay. See if I care.
The galaxy's a big place. Try not to get killed.
I can take care of myself just fine.
Sarek's gone, and his spaceport is in flames.
Excellent. Those assault cannons hit my men hard, but they're pushing back to take the base. Darth Gravis will want to hear the details.
That I do. But first, I want to personally thank our champion. With Master Sarek's death, this planet's reconstruction will crumble. The civilians who escaped will spread news of his defeat. Soon, Taris will be completely ruined. A tribute to the power of the Sith, the Empire, and you.
That's good news.
Your victory will be long remembered. With the Republic crushed, we can destroy this planet in peace, especially now that Thana's gone on to torment another world. Thanks to your actions, Taris will stand as a shining testament to the Empire's supremacy. And you will enter history as the intelligence operative responsible for this planet's downfall.
Hey, I'm worried your shooting's a little off. All that tech stuff wearing you down. We ever go blasters only. Your kill count won't look good next to mine.
I appreciate the advice. But there's nothing wrong with my marksmanship.
Aw, don't be like that. You'll spoil my mood. No one hunting me down, no exes mooning over me. Last time I cleaned house, I was playing anarchist on Brentel. Feels good to be free again.
After all we did, I'd think some of it would trouble you.
You don't understand me, do you? It's okay. You amuse me anyway. I've been thinking, though. Now that I'm not looking over my shoulder, might be time to move on. I could go after a big score, try something other than spy games. You could come with me.
I'm not going anywhere. I have a job to do.
Why do I even bother? Forget I said anything.
Last night, we ate our first ration bar since leaving the nest. We savored the flavor for 2 hours. We could taste every nutrient, every chemical compound and trace of foil. Do you know what joining the Kilix does to a person's senses?
Should I be sending you on more nighttime missions?
We can't see into every spectrum or smell poison under our nose, but our eyesight has improved. That does bring up something we want to discuss. How do you see our role as operative on your team?
I'm not sure what you're getting at.
Keeper described us as a covert assault agent. Our role as Dawn Herald gives us that capacity. We just don't know if that's the only reason we're here, or if it should be.
If there's information you have or aid you can provide, tell me. I'm still learning your talents.
So are we, in a sense. But, Agent, our whole life, we've been a diplomat. Whatever else we become, perhaps we shouldn't abandon that so readily.
In your head. You can't keep it there.
This is Leggett to Base Command. I have retrieved the ultrawave transmitter.
Base Command here. Connect the Gadara device to your link hub. I'll download what I need. The Special Forces team found Kai Zazen dead with her guards. I'll have to inform the Jedi Council.
Are you going to explain it?
I'll give them as much of the truth as I can. Maybe they'll learn from their mistakes. Download's complete. Let's hope the genius in that thing helps us win this war.
It's breaking your skull. Can you hear it crack?
You don't look so good, Leggett. Take a few days. Check in with your bosses. We'll have another job soon.
Can you see? Cipher 9. Leggett. Disposable operative. It's been a while since Shadow Town.
I can't move. I can barely think. What's going on?
When you met me on Nar Shaddaa, I was designated Watcher X, formerly Watcher 5, formerly Minder 8. I performed surgery on you before you murdered me. A chip in your spine to disguise your life readings. Maybe that chip is how we're talking now, or maybe it's the stress. Double agent, triple agent. The brainwashing damages your mind.
Only the SIS knows about the programming. I can't even talk about it.
I was in your position once, trapped by my conditioning, forced to subvert it. I warned you they'd do the same to you. The SIS isn't to blame. We both know you were programmed before you met them.
If the SIS didn't brainwash me, who did?
You've seen brainwashing technology before. Slave control serums on Drummond cars, loyalty instincts bred into watchers, an Imperial diplomat infused with Killick pheromones. The Republic is only using what the Empire put in your mind.
Imperial intelligence has never betrayed me.
Only because the necessity hasn't arisen. If you want freedom, if you want revenge, we need more information. Imperial intelligence will have records on Drummond Kaas. Take your personnel files from the Citadel archives. Ensure no one sees you. You have no allies now.
Readings are stable. Ah, our patient is awake.
Found you kissing the floor. You look like hell.
Prep the ship for flight. I need to pay a visit to the Citadel.
Of course. We'll be ready presently.
Yeah, sure. We can spend all the time with Keeper.
It's been a while since I played ship's doctor. There is something odd here, Cypher. Cypher, I've finished unpacking the last of my equipment. Between your ship's onboard systems and my custom apparatus, you'll soon have the finest in-flight laboratory in the sector.
This in-flight laboratory of mine, does it serve a particular purpose?
For now, I expect to find it occupied by the Rakghoul data we procured. But I'm sure we'll find other uses. Officially, of course, I'm in semi-retirement, monitoring background radiation somewhere in the Zetan Wastes. Unofficially, I'm very much looking forward to traveling with you.
What exactly is your position in Imperial Intelligence?
Let's just say the current administration is happy that I'm off Drummond Kaas. But they're willing to turn a blind eye. Should you need anything from me, you only have to ask. Although, if you want my genetic code rewritten, let me know before we leave the ship.
Make sure I'm in the loop on your work. Otherwise, no immediate requests.
Of course, this is going to be invigorating for both of us.
senses.
Thank you.
Hold a moment, please. Colonel Sarab, Commander, 75th Legion. Note this moment, Agent. Today, you are honored by an invitation into the service of the mighty Lord Vargo. The Republic schemes against us as we speak, but my Lord has foreseen their intentions, and he believes your organization's skills would be helpful in obliterating them.
With respect, matters like this are best handled by intelligence alone.
My master discovered this plot, no one else. Our troops are already deployed. You will share in our glory, or someone else will. You fought for Darth Gravis and saw the Republic's pathetic reconstruction. It shows nothing of the tremendous resources they received. My master determined that the Republic used those resources not only for rebuilding, but to construct a secret weapon. And my master is never wrong.
If even a fraction of those resources were used, the weapon could be substantial.
Precisely. It could even be a host of weapons. Lord Vargo determined the focus of the Republic's efforts prior to the invasion. We were deployed to search the area. Elite enemy commandos attacked us on arrival. We will find the Republic's secret there. With your help.
Show me where they're hiding and I'll flush them out.
A speeder will take you to Legion Base Camp, where Lord Vargo directs our operations. My master will show you the beauty of his vision, and you will join our Legion in honor and victory.
Let's get this done.
At your service, sir. Travel route is confirmed. Confirmed.
These Republic settlers just won't stop coming here. I'm Dr. Corvus, with Alien Control. I'm here to solve the Cathar problem.
You've piqued my curiosity.
Your expertise is most welcome, Agent. The Cathar's strength lies in their spirit. 9 times out of 10, they'll fight to their dying breath. So I've developed a serum that dampens the Cathar's inherent aggression. Less fight, more flight.
Would this serum be used on other species?
Sadly, no. Even the Bothans, for all their biological similarities, only develop a small rash when exposed to the formula. As of 26 minutes ago, my serum is approved and ready for a trial demonstration. The sight of their strongest warriors reduced to mewling runts ought to demoralize the Cathar nicely. Care to do the honors?
What exactly do you need?
I've prepared several special darts. The serum will kick in moments after it enters the Cathar's bloodstream. After that, I'd recommend waiting until they're good and pathetic before you finish them off. For effect.
Lord Vargo?
With respect, please. Refrain from disturbing my master. He is meditating deeply and dislikes interruptions. I'm Lieutenant Trell. Lord Vargo has authorized me to relay his instructions.
Let's get to the point.
Our hunt for the Republic's secret project is opposed by elite Special Forces soldiers. We must annihilate them to accomplish our goal. Our troops have encircled the region, maintaining pressure from all sides. While the enemy is thus distracted, you will strike directly at their forces and obliterate them.
What about searching for the Republic's project?
As you assault the enemy, you will also deploy small probes to help us pinpoint exactly where the Republic is hiding this secret weapon they've been constructing.
Seems like a smart choice.
There is one other matter. The leader of the Republic Defenders, Major Camden. His death could only speed our progress. Camden coordinates his soldiers from a heavily fortified base. It's practically impenetrable. If you were to hijack a Republic speeder, though, you might be able to get inside.
You forget who you're speaking to. I'll handle it.
Be cautious. Camden is a shrewd leader with extensive cyborg enhancements. He will not fall easily. Here are the probes you'll need to deploy. My fellow soldiers can tell you best how to strike at the enemy's forces. Good luck.
Agent of the Empire's machinations, do your work. Dismantle the cruel Republic minions who have taken my children.
What's happened to your children?
My children! My beautiful Rakghouls! The children of all Sith! Those marvelous, precious creatures! The Sith created them, and Darth Malak gave them this beautiful kingdom in which to multiply and grow strong! But now, the Republic is trying to steal Taris from them and destroy them! We must protect them!
Just tell me where to go.
The cruel Dr. Vernon leads the Republic's experiments to eliminate the Rakghouls. Destroy his equipment! Wipe out his research! Kill him!
Smell that! Scorched men, smoldering vegetation, and dissipating heat. Only victors get to savor that smell. Victors, and men thankful they're still breathing at all. They're out there right now, clinging desperately to the hope they'll drive us back. They have no idea how wrong they are.
Who's out there right now?
Remnants of the battalion we smashed here are lurking in the wilderness, hounding our every step. That ends now. My men revived a Republic soldier left behind when we decimated their main force. He's generously explained how their people are signaling each other. All that remains is to assemble the small elite unit that will have the honor of the final stroke.
Should be straightforward.
The goal is simple. The execution will not be. The enemy has short-range transmitters hidden in the region to broadcast vital alerts. We can use them to send an all-clear, then eliminate everyone who responds. We've got one opportunity to finish this. Failure will mean enduring guerrilla strikes every step we take. Your participation would make victory certain.
Let's get this done.
These are the coordinates of the transmitters. Make those curs wish they'd never been born.